And ask them what their needs are.
Okay.
So medic, technology, food. Let them tell the world what their needs are. Cool? Right. So I'm going to attach this here. Make sure you keep an eye on your framing. You know what the camera sees. Because they're seeing this. Cool? All right. And then you're good to go.
I'm plugged into right here. So that's just the webcam.
You're free.
All right. Bye, you guys.
Bye. Watch out, Sonny. Get better.
I'll be back with the checks.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Also, introduce him to Hitch, too. I love that
guy. Hitch? Okay. Well, Hitch is in the chat right now.
Hey, what's going on? What is this supposed to be? Why are you squeezing me with your body?
We got some real live love going on right here.
Some Occupy Pittsburgh loving right here. Right here.
Hey, help, okay, someone's touching me. We're live. You're squeezing me with your body.
This is Liza right here doing the medic stuff. Could you, even though you're being hugged, tell us what your needs are at the moment? What your needs are here at this camp?
Stop. Let me see it. I'm going to wipe it off.
You're on. No.
We're on live.
We need oil of oregano soft gels. That is an antiviral, antibiotic, antiparasitic, antifungal supplement. Oil of oregano soft gels. We also need tea tree oil and some more wool socks. We could use an EpiPen desperately. Also some sage, preferably white sage, preferably dried. Some more comfrey, valerian root tincture would be great. Various dried herbs would be much appreciated. Most of the things we already have, and to anyone who donates, we really gladly appreciate it, and really, really grateful for everyone who's willing to help us.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Sunny.
Yeah. Let me try to fix this camera. Well, maybe it's okay. I'm having trouble seeing.
If you got a
paper, Liza's been kidnapped. Show off that library.
This is the library right here. We have lots of good reading materials and free information for anybody who would like to partake. Right. Moving on to the kitchen. This is the kitchen.
Thank you, kitchen.
We fill our bellies with good, healthy food. Hey, kitchen. You guys are on live stream right now. Would you like to tell any needs that you guys have?
Okay. Is there specific things you need here? Right now,
food, very plain and simple. We need more healthy foods because we've been eating a lot of like pastries and donuts.
Yes.
And God knows we can't live off of that.
Yeah. If you're delivering it here, it should be like ready to eat type of thing. So like, you know, granola, fruit and vegetables. We actually have a lot of fruit. Just vegetables would be awesome.
Vegetables.
And anything, any other like kind of like produce or anything that can be prepared into a meal should be taken to the offsite kitchen, which is at 258 39th Street in Lawrenceville, which is the Food Not Bombs kitchen. And anything you can bring is appreciated.
Thank you guys.
Thank everybody for all of their help and support.
Yes.
Now, love you guys.
Okay, we need women's clothing, we need jeans and underwear, boxer shorts, briefs, whatever you can help out with.
Socks?
So, well, we got abundance of socks. Yeah, but if you want to bring some more, there's no problem with that.
Anything you're not wearing.
Is that it?
That's it.
You want to tell everybody your name?
Name is John. I take care of the comfort tent. Oh, and if possible, if you can bring some racks or some milk crates so we can use them as shelves.
Okay.
Thank you, John.
Let's see if you walk around. This is the info tent right here.
Mic check.
Hey, you guys. This is live.
Do you have
right
contact
now
for them?
Do you want to meet? Are you in a meeting?
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Are you streaming?
Yes, I'm streaming.
Why is it raining?
I don't know.
Stop,
why don't you ask our audience why it's raining?
Yo, is there McDonald's food out there?
Yeah.
Yo, can you hook me up?
Any needs here at all? I'm walking around asking if anybody needs anything.
Yeah, I have a lot of needs.
You have a lot of needs. We all do. We all do. Can you tell, like, more specific? Yes, I do.
Things that I need.
Things that...
Hard,
I need Silas to make me some handouts.
Handouts?
That's true.
Oh, you know what I need? Is I need someone to make me a frequently asked questions list.
Frequently asked questions.
That's a good.
Yeah,
good one.
We're gonna make a pamphlet thing. It's gonna have frequently asked questions on it, so I don't have to keep answering the same questions.
Thank you. Is that just about it?
Table.
There's so many things. A table.
Tables
for
hospitality would be great. Show the table. Yeah. Preferably as gaudy as this one. That'd be fantastic.
Something like this.
Preferably as gaudy as this one. Nice mold and so forth. It's just
or
very nice.
Just something in your dumpster now. Throwing out.
Exactly.
Okay, so these tables, I guess probably I would make a note on tarps. Intense.
So what I'm gonna do is just put little
I agree with that.
Equipment from the weather. Okay, I'm gonna say bye to the media or the info tents.
Thank you.
Bye, you guys. Thank you so much.
Did they clean out the porta johns yet?
No.
And we're walking.
We should make a point of that.
Hello, how are you guys doing on live stream right now? Would you like to say anything to our audience?
Hi.
Here. Hello.
I'm down.
We really need is help cleaning all these porta-johns.
Come here. Let's
okay, we're going to go look at the drawings. We have a lot of natural needs that we need to release because we fill our bellies and then have nowhere to put it. So we come back out. So we're going to walk over here to the Mr. Johns and I will show you our...
One thing we really do need is for somebody to help us to get these porta-johns right here cleaned out. So I'm trying to show them. Show the number. This is the number to call to have them cleaned out, but at the moment, we're not exactly sure. Maybe we can't afford to clean them out or what it is, but everybody is having to use other restaurants to use the restroom, and they're cutting us off, so we...
Restaurants don't want us to come in and not buy something and use the bathroom.
Yeah, so we really need help with this. This is an important one.
I'm going to show you. It's
raining.
Okay. All right. It's raining, so we're walking to
back to the
cover. Tip. Oh, my goodness. I need like an umbrella or something. There's a computer. And we're walking very rapidly here. Yeah, it's raining. We're going. I was showing Mr. Johns. We're back into the umbrella. Yeah, actually, we came by here already. I took the picture and the checker tent. Okay, all right.
Hey,
again.
Hello. Any of you guys have any like political views that you'd like to share or any like any kind of information that you'd like
politics,
to tell?
So I hate politics.
Okay.
Corporations and the state, no good.
Corporation and state, no good?
Nope. End them.
Get rid of money in politics. Stop allowing our politicians to be bought and sold by corporations. I think if you actually get money out of politics, a lot of these problems would be solved because the politicians would be more accountable to the people. So that's probably my biggest concern.
Again, 9/11.
What's that? What'd you say?
I don't think so. I think it's very cool. It is.
Exactly.
I thought it's very cool.
Why do you think it's pathetic?
Why do you think it's pathetic? Again, 9/11. I'm talking to you.
Get outside
and
shower!
It's raining, so free showers for everyone. The umbrella was in the way. Incoming with live stream. This is the info storage lost and found. We take care of items that are found. And if you lose anything, you can come here and get it. Okay, moving on. So this is the camp. We're pretty busy here, actually. We're getting a lot of people. This is a beautiful musician over here. Lovely singer. I would love to actually catch you playing something.
Oh.
Really cool. I think we've tried to involve music into this event because it's really important to bring people here. And maybe if they come here and they hear music and it attracts just people. Just there, you're in the spotlight. But maybe they'll come here and hear more information and actually find something interesting that they may want to partake in this movement. They had not heard before.
This one.
Thank you very much.
This right here is the comfort tent.
This is the comfort tent. This is all of our supplies
this is where,
we have at the moment.
Yes, this
well,
is a lot
of boots,
but there really is a need for other things such as extra clothes for people to stay warm,
yes,
maybe
yes.
tarps.
Sleeping bags.
And if anybody could bring a few more little pop tents to help us out, because some people are just sharing tents that they can barely fit in. Right now.
Yes, this is true.
And it's a little
also,
rough.
Also, I want to add for the kitchen, we need any kind of silverware and cups and anything to hold food in.
But not styrofoam.
Not styrofoam. Trying to make it so that we don't have to throw a whole bunch of stuff away.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. See that clash collision over here.
That's awesome. Right. I got
the
eyes.
Running the into the camera. Okay, let's look. Yeah, we're live streaming.
That is the reason of my
Oh, wait, get the thing over. This is a beautiful drawing right here that caught my eye. Over here. We got the squid. He's
the Federal Reserve.
He's grabbing all these.
He represents the Federal Reserve. That's why it says reserve over his forehead. And the money is pouring out of his mouth into the Wall Street and wrapped around farms, banks, factories. I think it's just a very good explanation of what we're here for today and every day we're here.
Okay, moving on. We have like a fence wrapped around these monuments in the middle, but people have demonstrated their own opinions here and have put a lot of art and a lot of work into this. They ask questions. I like that.
There are a few things here that maybe some may disagree with and others agree with, but that's the point. Is
well,
that
we all have different beliefs here, yeah. All of us.
But
the point is we're all getting together and we're trying to change all kinds of things that, like, despite other opinions, are going wrong. This is a door. Let's see what's, I'm sure
Where's
you guys have seen this one. Here's the tent.
Oh. Is your guitar still getting fixed? Or?
It's gonna be, yeah. He's gonna go.
We're filming live right now.
Yeah.
Oh, you're
actually
live.
If you wanna, I would love to like get some music on here, show people
well,
like how.
I was just talking to this dude right here. He's looking to get some music going.
Yeah. Well, we need a guitar. You guys would like to see some music, right? There you go. This isn't really. This is just a poster. Nothing wants to say right here. You can't give people freedom. People gotta get freedom for themselves. That's what we're doing out here. That's right. We need lots of volunteers and we need people to get involved. Okay, that's enough of that one.
Yeah, let's not see it.
Hey, you guys, can I ask a question? So what do you guys think would help more? Like, how could we be more active? Any ideas here?
No, she's talking to somebody on the computer. I'm
taping you guys.
What are you asking, Mark?
I'm asking, what do you think that we could do to be more active? Like, how can we make this more of a daily thing and get more people involved?
Keep on doing what we're doing.
Keep on doing what we're
doing.
Just,
yeah, occupy where we are. Keep it peaceful. But spread the word that we're here and we're fed up.
I saw San Diego. They seem to be kicking ass. I think that
Jacksonville
too. We need more people in Pittsburgh. I think.
Yeah, and
we do.
I think
need more than just more people. We need
I think
more
the best
people
way,
to be active.
I think the best way for us to foster better communications with the populace out here. Because we got people that walk by that look in and they're like, well, I want to go in there, but not really sure what they're about. I'm with the Arts and Entertainment Media Work Group. There's about three of us, I think, on that bottom line. And we're looking for artists to come out so we can keep, you know, constant music here to incite, to get the public's interest up to where they will actually walk in. And then also with the arts tent itself, we would love to be able to get like some, if you guys have a media person out there and that's listening to this over the internet that knows how to do flyers and things like that with the computer, we could really use that to actually put our mission statement out and what we're here for in Occupy, to let the general public know that we're here for them, we're here for the 99%, and that we are going to take down these corporations, but we need everyone's help all across the country to get this done.
Do you need any supplies for your art tent?
Yes, we do. We are taking constant donations.
We're trying to take down the corporations, but more so to make it more fair.
Yeah, to make it more fair and to put the pensions back, and the money back into the private sector so we can get more people and teachers back into these schools. We lose the teachers, we're going to lose our education and the quality of it. It's already lacking as it is because of teachers being laid off. They're laying off all the good teachers because they want, a little bit more extra benefits, for all the hard work they're doing and keeping all the crappy teachers that'll work for anything, But, yeah, we are, as far as the donations, like you were asking, we are taking donations for the Arts and Entertainment Tent, as well as a lot of the other work groups here that are working in conjunction with the whole Occupy movement to foster connections with the general public. The arts, what we really need is like a laptop. If anyone's selling one for cheap, contact any of us. You can go. We have a email set up, as well as you can contact Paradise Gray and also the OccupyPittsburgh.org website has contact information for Dylan Rook as well as Paradise Gray. You can find me on Twitter at GP Chile. That's GPCHILLE. And send me a message there, if you know anyone that's selling computers, for a cheaper price. We also need paints. We need more poster board, hardboard, anything to make signs. And
any kind of paint?
No oil paint, just acrylic. Acrylic and stuff that won't wash off if it gets rained on like it is now. But yeah, we're taking all costs and donations because we do not get paid for anything we do. We're here of our own volition, and we're trying to make this a successful movement. So any donations for any part of this camp is greatly accepted.
Right on.
Are you putting this out on the internet?
It's on right now.
Right now. People are watching this right now, yes. they're commenting on it. They're talking to us.
If you go to Jim Quinn at War Room, WARROOM, talk to Jim or Rose. They're media people out of Pittsburgh, but he has a nationwide show. Write him an email. Just let them know what we're trying to do, maybe, hopefully, we could get him and Rose involved.
Right on. Right on.
Thank you very much.
We've got Democracy Now! Involved, too. That's really cool.
Yeah, you want to tell that to everybody?
I just wanted to say we've already have our local radio station that works with Democracy Now! Involved right now. So if you guys are in Pittsburgh, there is a radio station. It is 88.3. It's FM. 88.3 FM. And Democracy Now! Is on there. They're also talking about everybody in the world on NPR about this Occupy thing right now, too. So if you listen to NPR or anything like that, you can learn a lot about what's going on as well if you're not getting enough here, or if you'd like to hear it from the outside aspect instead of the inside aspect.
Thank you very much.
Maybe it's AM. Is it AM?
Am I going to run into anything? I'm just looking at the sign. Well, let's walk. We're going to walk around and see a little bit more of art.
It really hard.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to look around at everything.
Don't
we have free literature, which is getting rained on right now.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, but we're looking around, and nobody is protesting at the moment because it is raining outside.
That's
an excuse. I know, it's not. People should be out here. Let's see this wonderful person.
Let's go talk to this mom. Let's go talk to this mom standing in rain.
Protesting.
gift certificates available.
Well, I don't think that's what the sign actually says on the other side.
That would be funny, though.
Yeah. What we got going on here?
Let's see. Let's check out this awesome mama right here.
You are standing, sitting in the rain, protesting. Now that is spirit. What does your sign say?
Honk, you love, war, man. Your freedom, what does the bottom one say?
Your freedom is paid by the blood of a veteran. What is your name?
Diana.
Michelle, you're on live stream right now. Do you have anything you want to say?
Just honk if you're love, war, war, man.
Let's see all these beautiful signs out here. They're getting wet.
Let's see the trickle down sign.
The trickle down. This is my favorite
this
sign.
This is everybody's favorite
right
sign.
Right here.
It's great.
This is awesome. Look at that beautiful art. Piece of work there. Yep, and that's up for everybody to see all the time. And we are steadily getting more signs up for all the cars who pass right here. Here we go. Occupy Pittsburgh.
There's a bunch of the same sign that everybody is welcome to take a piece off of and supply
themselves. We have signs where if you feel like protesting, you can come grab a sign. Lots of them, enough with a lot of different
veterans. Veterans for Peace made a bunch of these signs and brought it to us so that we can use these signs to fly as well. And these signs you can hang out in the rain or anything else. So if anybody doesn't know exactly what kind of sign to make or something, I think they're making a good point is how is the war economy working for you? That's a good sign to fly for a lot of marches. And they gave us a whole bunch of those for their own agenda, I'm sure. But, you know, sometimes their agenda is good with our agenda.
Yeah, let's move on here. Here's another one. Occupy
to liberate.
And, occupy to liberate. Thank you. Hello, how's it going, you guys? No good. We're on live stream right now. Veterans for Peace. There we go.
Here's the Democracy Now sign right here.
Democracy Now, okay.
Democracy Now, 88.3 FM. And they're talking about us a whole lot on there. They've been up here interviewing people on the radio, live interviews actually. And I think they're doing a lot for us as well because a lot of people listen to them.
Yeah.
And a lot of times people see a camp with a bunch of tents out and stuff and they just think that people are out here because they don't have jobs and things like that. But it's not that.
I want to make a note, a lot of people out here are working.
I would say the majority of people out here have jobs, definitely. There's actually very few people that are originally homeless that are out here and very few people that are not working. So if anybody sits there and yells out, oh, I got a job, well, guess what? So do we.
Okay. Days of occupation. How long have we been here? I think it probably has like a big
one. It does. It was a mark together.
I believe this is day 9.
Day 9 that we've been out here.
I'm sorry. I don't know if you guys can see that. Yeah, they can.
Can see that.
Okay. Well, I want to see if I can catch some music, but it looks like it's
nobody
rain.
Is
nobody
playing.
Nobody's going to have their guitar.
You want to go to Canadian Club?
Canadian Club? Okay, let's go to Canadian Club.
Maybe somebody's playing music out there.
Walk around. A Canadian Club has nothing to do with Canada. This is just the name of the the name of the umbrella. We are walking to the Canadian Club.
This way.
Yeah, careful. Watch the.
I'm trying.
There we go. Stuff. We're on live stream, sir. Do you want to be on live stream?
I know, I can explain to you.
Oh,
guys.
Yeah, okay.
So you had some cover.
Wait, get it, keep it on the thing. Walk with me.
Now
you
I
like
know
to
how
say
you do
something.
The umbrella trick.
Yes. Oh, did you think we were just out here with a.
I don't know. We have a way of doing it with like putting a trash bag over the computer.
Oh yeah, that would like work too. But I wouldn't be able to see.
You can do it just like that.
Yeah, the umbrella is nice.
Okay. Well, this is what you may call the Canadian
club. What? That's mean, you guys. Hey, anybody want to be on live stream? Anybody have anything they want to say?
Can I chime in over
Jesus here?
Jesus coming back.
I
would like to say something, actually.
Something productive, other than Jesus is coming back.
Yeah, we need Jesus here.
I for one, I'm over here. Hello. Can you see me?
Yeah, you're on. You're on.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I, for one, just want to say that with living my whole life of 19 years, I've never in one spot in my life besides this camp and besides this protest seen so many caring and loving people and so much peace in one area. I really feel safe and peaceful. And, you know, this should be an example of what the whole world should be like, this little camp.
That's
what I have to say.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah,
we're Canadian club.
Okay, moving on.
You ready to go back to the media?
I guess so. It's raining pretty hard right now.
It's raining, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. I wish we could catch a little bit more going on here.
Well, there's not much. I don't want everybody's inside. Everybody is inside their tents because they don't want to take daily showers.
Yeah. There's a lot of dirty hippies here, yeah.
No, there's not. That's not even true. Just her.
Walk with me. It's getting...
Dude, I am.
Hey, you guys, coming through. It's raining kind of hard. Okay, I'm going to make it through.
Hi.
Hello.
We're
still live right now.
Oh, good. I want to do an interview.
Can you see something?
Well, I want to do an interview with someone.
Oh, you
do you mind?
You want to steal this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see. What's the lighting look like in here? Well, it's not too bad at all.
Yeah, it's not. It's been a pretty good picture.
Could you set it up in a way so that she could sit in that chair and be visible?
Sit in this chair?
Well, I was thinking
right there.
In terms of lighting, yeah, this would probably be best. And I'm going to put my camera away.
How was that?
I wasn't looking.
I kind of want to watch it now.
Get away.
Hi.
Okay. If you guys didn't notice, it's raining outside.
I've been out. Yeah.
All right. Can you watch out? I'm going to bring in someone for an interview.
Put a chair right here.
Thank you.
Anything? Will you sit down right here and then...
I can't sit down.
To see if it's seeing the person. I want to see the head. Yeah, it just straight up misses the head.
Okay. You need to just bend this up. How's that? Like that?
There you go. And
yeah?
Now you're seen.
Good?
Yep.
Okay.
Cool. Awesome.
Thank you. Ooh, you know, sorry to hijack. I hope I'm not hijacking it. I just wanted to...
It's fine.
Is she off duty for a little bit? Can she take a break for a little bit?
Oh, yeah.
Totally. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
How are you feeling, by the way?
I'm feeling great today, actually. Just a little bit of vitamin C and stuff.
Who are you talking to? Because we're both kind of...
We're both feeling great.
I got sick last night.
Yeah,
we were
both very much taken care of by the medic, by Liza. She came by our tent later, actually, and brought some stuff for her cold and stuff, and brought some vitamins and stuff for me for the morning just to feel a little bit better.
I haven't eaten too
Mary
much.
Beth?
I'm gonna go get some food.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Mary
let's
Beth?
Let's go have our little...
Can you ask call for Mary Beth? Oh, here she comes.
Are you Mary Beth?
Okay. I didn't know.
Thank you. Have a seat. We're about to go live with an interview with Mary Beth Seislinger. And let's see if we're... Say something.
Hey, all.
Okay. Let me move down a little bit. And down a little bit higher. Okay. So... Hi, this is David again. I'm sure you're tired of seeing my face and my scraggly beard. But right now I'm here with Mary Beth Seislinger, who is with the... Well, tell us, who are you and who are you with?
Okay, great.
And
first of all, I want to say thank you to you. And I don't think people should be tired of seeing your face when you're willing to give the time and the attention that you are.
You have to speak up because of the sound.
I'm just saying that I'm appreciating him for his efforts, and I think anyone who's willing to put themselves out there should be well appreciated. My name is Mary Beth Steislinger, and I am a commons advocate for what in this country is loosely known as the commons movement. Across the world, it could be known as different things, rights of nature movement, customary law, empowerment for people and their resources. But it's a way basically that community groups, civil society, basically everyone that's not government and is not the private sector, not business, is starting to organize themselves around the world. And I think the Occupy movement, you know, in my mind, is definitely a movement of the people. And in that sense, it's very much a lively commons movement. And I'm part of this larger network of people that are doing commons advocacy work, both at the level of their local neighborhoods and at the level of the United Nations. I work with a group called Commons Action for the United Nations. And here in Pittsburgh, I work with lots of local nonprofits, from urban eco-stewards groups to bike advocacy groups to men's shelter, women's shelter, homeless advocacy, a lot of different things along those lines. So one of the things I wanted to bring to Occupy Pittsburgh is this really great list of 8 design principles. I know you can't really see it, but I'll tell you a little bit about it. From a really neat woman named Eleanor Ostrom, who is kind of the grandmother of the commons movement in this country, in that she's been studying it for 30 years. And what they found was whenever people get together and organize to protect a resource or protect value in their communities, they, if they're successful, they're using at least, you know, a few of these 8 design principles, if not all of them. And so this is one of the things I brought down today to share with the group, and I'd love to have a discussion sometime with folks. I left a bunch of handouts here. But should I go ahead and read them, or is that too boring?
Why don't you just read them, and then I'd like to ask you to explore one of them.
Okay.
And then, you know, we're going to be here a while, so hopefully Mary Beth will be here a while, not just today, but as we go on throughout the winter, talking, or fall and winter, you know, where we explore some of these. And one thing in particular would be to sort of monitor how some of these principles are applied or investigated within the context of our occupation. But for now, let's just start off by hearing what are the 8 principles and talk about one of them.
Absolutely. The idea of these principles is that they can be applied to very local, distinct processes, and they can also be shared with similar processes to scale it up to the regional, state level, and ideally even eventually the global level. Thus far, we don't really have any commons that are commonly managed on the global scale. So most of the time, you know, we're kind of fighting for climate change to be addressed globally, and that's really, I think, our best hope to address global commons collectively. But back to the local level, this is where we're really learning what works and what doesn't. And
can I suggest you start with reading the definition at the bottom of the page?
Sure. And Dave is asking me to read the definition of the commons, which I have here at the bottom. And the commons are gifts of nature and society, the wealth we inherit or create together and must pass on, undiminished or enhanced, to our children. A sector of the economy that complements and counterweights the corporate sector. And to me, that's very key, because right now we have obviously very powerful governments and very, very powerful businesses, corporations, multinationals, and the people really are yet to be organized in a force that can successfully challenge those two entities. I call it the corporate state. Some people call it the market state. And yet we're getting close, and I think the Occupy movement is a very clear indication of that. And I'm very excited to see how we, the people, are going to take a lot of these design principles, these wonderful 8 design principles for well-managed, protected commons, and put them into action across scales, across borders. And it's happening. So let's start with the first principle. It's called clearly defined boundaries. If you want to protect a commons, you need to clearly define what those boundaries are for that commons. and you need to be very clear on who is allowed to participate in that comments and who needs to be effectively excluded if they don't have the right or they have not put the time in or they have not really participated in such a way that they can claim themselves as a stakeholder. So that's the first thing, clearly defined boundaries. Number two is rules regarding the appropriation and provision of commons resources are adapted to local conditions. I'll say that in a little less academic language. Proportional costs and benefits, i.e., it is important that those who are involved participate, work, support, and get benefits in proportion to their efforts. So that's a really key thing, because I think one of the things that a lot of people will criticize about movements like this is, oh, those folks are just a bunch of freeloaders, you know? Well, no, that's not the case. But we have to be very clear with ourselves and with our coworkers and collaborators that, you know, there are responsibilities here. What are they? So we as the community need to put them together. Number three is consensus decision-making. People will work hard for decisions they help to make. Now, you know, from what I've seen in the Occupy movement, they are doing pretty well with this. I know there's been people breaking off and trying to do their own thing, and they get good criticism right away from the rest of the group to say, hey, you know, this is a group decision. You need to be part of the process, show up and, you know, put your ideas forward, but don't try to undermine what the group is trying to do. So it's very, very important. Eleanor Ostrom would say in her academic language, effective monitoring by monitors who are part of or accountable to the resource users, and kind of more in lay terms, monitoring. Most want to cooperate, but, you know, if there's a temptation for all of us to slack off, oh, someone else will do the work. David will do the work. Thanks, David. you know, that's really not cool. That a few can actively game the system. They can say, yeah, I've been one of the organizers, and they've really not done their share of the work. So there needs to be very good guidelines set up and someone who's monitoring to check in with people and say, come on now, we need your help. You know, this doesn't have to be like the SS or anything. It can be, you know, people just checking in with each other to say, you know, can you please step up? Or we've noticed you've slacked off a bit, you know, something going on with you. You know, it's a human kind of process. So number five, there is a scale of graduated sanctions for resource users who violate community rules. And I think that's really, you know, that's a good idea, you know, especially if you have an Occupy site like this and you have someone who's continuously creating disruptions, breaking community guidelines. What do? You know, what's your policy when you have something like that happen? Number six, mechanisms of conflict resolution are cheap and of easy access. So what Eleanor Ostrom has found, when people do a good job protecting their community value, their community worth, their community process, they've got someone to monitor and someone to actually intervene for conflict resolution. So who's your conflict resolution team? Who are the people that are particularly skilled with conflict resolution? Who can you go to quickly in a conflict and get it resolved before it turns, you know, really nasty or difficult? Number seven is the self-determination of community users or community managers is recognized by higher level authorities. So who are the authorities that we've set up in our so-called democracy? Well, right now there are local governance, our state governance, county governance, state governance, national governance, the UN. And, you know, some multilateral institutions, perhaps, that we might think of as governing bodies. In a lot of ways, they may not be really representing the needs of the people. And this is where the rub comes in. This is where we really need to do our work, I think, you know, to really scale this up. So who are our allies in governance? And how can they really come to the table and make governance co-governance? What does that really mean? What does that look like? And we need to spell that out. We need to say what that looks like. We need to define it. And the last one, number eight, and this is kind of the evolutionary step for humanity. You know, we've been able to do small protection of the commons around the world. You know, the tragedy of the commons is when these eight principles aren't used, or when a corporation comes in and closes the commons. That's the tragedy. Mm-hmm. So the tragedy is when we don't use these principles. And the biggest thing is, if we want to use these principles in a big way to have collective benefit for communities and the earth, we need to do number eight really well. And that is, in the case of larger common pool resources, we need to figure out ways to form organizations in multiple